In this video, we're going to take a look at the new subsurface scattering support in the summer 2018 release. So we've added new subsurface scattering shaders. And so here in this project, I'm going to come over here to my shader settings. And you can see that I have the PBR metal rough selected as the shader. And then here you can see that we have a new category for subsurface scattering parameters. Here we have just a global enable switch. So if I turn this on and off, you can see that I can disable and enable subsurface scattering here for my material. Now, in order to visualize the subsurface result, we need to add a scattering channel to our texture set. So here on this particular texture set, I'm gonna come over here to the texture set settings, and you can see here for my channels, there is a scattering channel that's been created. So here you would just click the plus button, and actually here, let me just undock this window. You click the plus button, and here within the dropdown, you'll see a scattering channel. You just add this here to your texture set, and you'll be ready to start working with subsurface scattering. So with this channel enabled here on the fill layer, you can see that here for the material, again, scattering is enabled, and you have a slider here that allows you to set the scattering amount. In this case, the value is set to 1. Here, if I set this back to 0, again, you can see that we are effectively just turning off the scattering. So we can adjust how much of an effect that we want for the subsurface. In the particular case of this asset, the value was set to 1. And this effect is being driven by the mass that's being created here for this fill layer. So here you can see there's several fills and a level. If we take a look at the mass that's being created, and just so we can more clearly see this, I'm going to just solo this body texture set. Here's the mass that's being created. And if we drop into here, we can take a look at the subsurface scattering channel. So here I'll go back to my material, and again, just alt left click so we can see the mass. So this is the mass that's being created that's driving here the scattering amount. So to work with subsurface scattering, you just need to have a scattering channel. You need to set an amount. And then here on your shader settings, you just need to make sure that subsurface scattering is enabled on the shader that you're going to be using. Now we have a set of shaders that are compatible with the subsurface scattering parameters. And that's going to be the PBR metal rough, the PBR spec gloss, the PBR coated, and the metallic roughness alpha. The subsurface used in the real-time viewport is based on state-of-the-art research from Pixar, and it will automatically translate to iRay when you switch into the iRay rendering mode. Now, for this, we have two scattering types. We have skin and translucent. Translucent uses a volumetric approach to scattering the light in iRay, while skin uses the diffuse. It's less physically accurate, but closer to the real-time result, and it's much faster to compute when in iRay. Translucent is suited for any type of material that absorbs light more or less deeply, like jade jewelry, and skin is, well, good for skin because it has a minimal absorption. So here we have our two types, and in this case here, we have the scattering type set to skin, and then you have your scale. So this scale slider here is like a global control, again, adjusting the scale of the subsurface effect. And then here we also have your color, which is the color of light that's absorbed by the material. So now I'm going to come over here to our display settings, and if we look through here, you'll notice that under the display settings, we have activate subsurface scattering here. And again, this is a global control where we can turn off subsurface scattering, but here you have this sample count. So if we just kind of zoom in pretty close here, and I'm going to take the sample count down to something really low. So here you can see the level of quality that we're getting from this very low sample count of 4. And as we increase this, we're starting to kind of blur this result and get a more clean render here in the viewport. Now, just note that the higher that you drag this value to, the slower the performance you'll have here in the viewport. So you just need to make sure that you have a trade-off for, you know, the quality that you want versus the performance that you're getting here in the 3D view. So here we are in the iRay rendering mode, and you can see that we have our tabs here for the display settings and the shader settings. And on the shader settings, I have access to the subsurface scattering parameters. Again, we've set this mode to skin, which again, like I said earlier, is not as physically accurate as translucent, but it's much faster to compute here in iRay. We also have access to our scale and our color. And of course, we can enable and disable the subsurface scattering. In this example, I have a project that was created in a previous version of Substance Painter, and now I've opened this here in the summer 2018 release. So I'm gonna come over here to my display settings, and let's see, if I scroll down here to where I have the activate subsurface scattering and I enable this here, you can see that I'm starting to get this kind of pink result. So what I need to do is update my shaders. Now there's a couple ways we can do that. If I take a look at my texture set, I'm on this face here. Right now, all of these texture sets are using the same shader. So what I'm gonna do in this case, I'm just gonna create a new shader instance. And now let's come over to the shader properties, and this I'm just gonna call skin. And you'll notice here that this PBR metal rough with alpha blending is outdated. So I can actually change that here if I like, or set it to a new shader altogether. So in this case here, I'm just gonna set this here to a new PBR metal rough, and you can see I still have my subsurface. And I'm doing this here because, you know, I may want to have some texture sets use subsurface and some other texture sets, like maybe for the metal and this leather here, to not use subsurface. However, I still have this issue where, you know, this material is kind of showing up as pink. So what I need to do is just update the shader. And like I said, we could do it manually there, or we could use the resource updater. So here I'm gonna come over to the resource updater, and you'll notice that we now have this new shaders tab. And this is showing me here that my PBR metal rough with alpha blending needs to be updated. So what I'm gonna do here is just click this update button. And so now the shader's been updated, and you can see I'm no longer seeing any pink here in the viewport, which means that the shader is out of date. So everything should be good to go at this stage. So again here, I'm just going to go back here to my texture set list, and again, I'm still working on my face. So here I'm gonna come over to my texture set settings, and for this project, since I'm using the new summer 2018 release, I want to be able to have this work with subsurface. What I'm going to do is just come over to my channel now, and I'm going to add a scattering channel here. So now that I have that in place, I can now just come over, create a fill layer. This is now going to represent my subsurface, and I'm just going to turn off all these channels here that I'm not using, because I just want to focus on scattering. And like I showed earlier in the video, if I just take my scattering amount and start to increase this, you can see here that I can see the scattering result. So what I'm going to do here is just create a black mask, and then within this mask I'm going to add a fill. And let's browse through this project here. I'm just going to filter this based on the project, and I'm going to find the thickness map that I baked. And here it is for the head. So now I'm going to use this, and I'm also going to just quickly create a levels here and then just invert this effect. So here I'm just using just a quick way of using the thickness map here, which has actually been inverted. So you can see this is what I have. I can even come into my levels and start to adjust, you know, some of the values here for this. So I might do something more like this. And again, I'll hit M on the keyboard to go back to my material. And so this is just a quick way for me to start to build up this subsurface effect. And another thing I might do, again, if I'm taking a look here at my mask, if I want to maybe, let's just drop back and take a look at some of the dirt. So here I have this dirt layer. And what I'm gonna do in this case is I'm gonna use my anchor point here to anchor in this dirt mask. I'm gonna go back here to my subsurface. So I basically kind of wanna subtract out this dirt here from the subsurface. So in this case, I'm gonna add a fill, and let's come over to our anchor points, and we're gonna grab this dirt mask here. And then I'll just come in and use a multiply into here. So now I'm able to, just using the anchor system, kind of subtract out the dirt from my subsurface mask. And then here, of course, I can come in and just adjust my opacity value for this. Here, once again, we'll drop back to our material mode. Let me just move my light around a bit just to kind of see what I'm getting here with the surface. And here again, if we take a look at our fill, this is the difference that we're getting. So it's starting to, again, concentrate this subsurface effect in the areas that I need it to be in based on this mass that I'm building up here. What's nice about being able to use these anchor points is if at any time I want to go back, change, like say the dirt generator, like perhaps maybe increase the dirt, that's automatically being passed up here to the subsurface mask because it's being anchored based on this fill layer, which is referencing the anchor point, and I don't have to make those changes. I don't have to make changes in the dirt and then have to manually propagate those to another layer. So when you have your previous project and you open that in the summer 2018 release, if you see any of the materials rendering as pink in the viewport, it just means that you need to update that shader, and you can do that manually by just coming over here to the shader settings and updating it, or you could just do it basically system-wide by using the resource updater and clicking on the shader tab, and here it'll show you any of the shaders that need to be updated, and you can just update them this way. So that's going to close out this video on the new subsurface scattering support. Subsurface works with two modes. We have skin and translucent. You can enable subsurface right on your shader. This is where you're going to set the color. Again, one other thing I just wanted to point out here. Notice that, you know, for my main shader, I set this to skin. So by using shader instances like this, when you have like a texture set list, let me just dock this guy over here. When you have a texture set list and maybe you want to have a different subsurface color for different materials or texture sets, you can use these shader instances so that you can set these at different scale values and different color values, as I've done here. Also here in the display settings, we have this activate subsurface, which is a global control, also allows us to adjust the sample count. So if you see a lot of noise, you can increase the sample count. Just be aware that the higher the sample count reaches, the lower the performance in your viewport will be. And all of the work you do to set up the subsurface here in the real-time shader will translate correctly over to Iray. So thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.